moving my feet. I like moving my feet. Hey, what's up, YouTube? It's Marvin again, back with some more music reactions. And you know what I want to do? I want to do something a little something different, a little something special in honor of Eminem's birthday, because it is Eminem's birthday today. I want to do kind of my introduction to Eminem, or at least some of his earlier music, because everybody knows the hits, right? If you're an Eminem fan, if you're a rap fan, you already know what the songs are that made him great. You know what I'm saying? The Lose Yourself and the Sing for the Moments and the earlier stuff like Hi, My Name Is and the whole Marshall Mathers LP. You know all that stuff, right? But I want to go back a little earlier than that, like, or at least around the same time frame when he worked with Sway and Tech in the Morning back in the day. And the song is none other than The Anthem from Sway and Tech, and it's featuring a collection of artists, some who's who of the time, people like the RZA, people like Eminem, obviously, Xzibit, Pharoah Monk, Kool G Rap, Chino XL, KRS-One, and of course my favorite rapper, Tech N9ne. You know what I'm saying? Which is like one of his first like national coverage type of songs where he was just now kind of getting his career started at the time. So I thought it was a really cool moment. Because as far as I know, I think Eminem and Tech N9ne have only collabed on two songs that I know of. One being this song and the other one being Speed 'Em, which is like one of the Worldwide Chopper series of songs that they came out with. So those are the only two that I know of, unless there's another one or some other ones that I haven't seen. But if you guys know about it, let me know. You know what I'm saying? Some of y'all would know more than me, or maybe I just missed something, or, you know, that's all good. And then also, I tried to put up another video earlier of Tech N9ne. Not Tech N9ne, of Eminem, but YouTube decided no. YouTube said no, you can't upload that video. So I disputed it. It might come out later, but it's for today as well. So if I do get it up, I'm gonna link it to this video as well and kind of put them together, and you'll kind of see what I'm talking about. Cause I tried, but YouTube was like, nah, put the block on it, put the brakes on that, buddy. So the copyright monster got me, but it's okay. So I wanna do I'm gonna go do the Anthem. You know what I'm saying? Kind of look at some earlier Eminem in his earlier days and just say, hey, salute to him. Happy birthday, you know what I'm saying, for Eminem. And just want to say what's up for all the things that he's done and continues to do, you know, behind the scenes until he drops some more music out. So that'd be kind of cool. So anyway, before I get started, I just want to say, hey, guess what the rules are? I'm probably going to pause this song throughout it. I've heard this song, but I just haven't heard it in a long time. So it'll be kind of more of a review than a reaction, but it's all good too. Cause I just want to like do this as a little special tribute. And then of course, like, comment, share, subscribe, comment below. You know what I'm saying? If you have any more input on this song, anything you like, of course, go ahead and put some more suggestions in there while you're at it. It's all good. And, I'll be kind of getting those, other suggestions out here. I've got a little book here in front of me of ones I'm going to do, over the course of the weekend. So anyway, without further ado, let me jump into the Wake Up Show Anthem, featuring a whole lot of artists, one of them being Eminem. Let's go. Wake Up Show. One, two. Gotta pause right there. Off the rip, you hear that classic boom bap beat. I'm pretty sure that RZA made the beat on this. It definitely sounds like a RZA production. You know what I'm saying? And you can always tell by the visuals that this is a little dated, but that's okay.
Bobby still staple tails, MCs get your lips stapled. project, chill the hell. It's stamped on the map like the compass. Take this foreplay, tongue twist, piercing holes in you. You can't escape 70,000 kilowatts, blast for your box, walking along clocks. Cars driving slow down the block, one stop parks, pops his trunk, stamp pops loud as block shots. Face like a grenade in your face, cops stop, give a citation. Report for radio station identification.
Wake up.
When I woke up, I grabbed the mic and never choked up. Busted a verse and all the G's and Cali loped up when I was up.
Got a pause right there for Tech N9ne.
Styles were mixed.
Oh, I gotta run that back though. Oh.
Face like a grenade in your face. Cops stop, give a citation. Report for radio station identification.
Wake up.
When I woke up, I grabbed the mic and never choked up. Busted a verse and all the G's and Cali loped up when I was summoned. Styles were mixed like the Drummonds. Killer clown.
He said styles was mixed like the Drummonds. You know what I'm saying? The little different strokes reference for y'all that, you know what I'm saying, to remember.
Coming, look around the town, it's crumbling. This big tech from the Midwest, leaving MCs lit less on the wake up show. Wake up, no stories about my shake up flow. Put me up in a cypher, partner. You came off with a sniper. Your flow's premature, clean your dirty diaper. Mike iced up, psycho.
He said, my flow's premature, clean your dirty diapers. Oh man, you know what I'm saying? Tech N9ne was a problem even back then, you know what I'm saying? Definitely back then, and the flow was crazy. You know what I'm saying? The wordplay is crazy. You know what I'm saying? Matter of fact, hold on. I know the song ain't too long, but I'm going to run that back.
My shake up flow, put me up in a cypher. Partner, you came off with a sniper. Your flow's premature, clean your dirty diaper. Mike heist up, psycho, alpha, schizo, hypno, cryo, gat flow, guru, and ain't nobody tighter. Sway and tech hurt me flowing it's sealed. Now I got Swedish women yelling, Tech N9ne's build.
This place is my house. I might as well erase.
There we go. There's Eminem. Let me run it back a little bit. Just a little bit.
Sway and tech hurt me flow when it's sealed. Now I got Swedish women yelling Tech N9ne's build.
This place is my house. I might as well erase my face with whiteout. Cause y'all can't see me like Mesa's eyebrows.
Where you at?
Climbed out of a nice house. Through the
even then the punchline, you can't see me like Mesa's eyebrow. Like Mesa and Betha, you know what I'm saying? Like from anyway.
Front window and heard this guy shout.
Hey,
pull a nine out during the rhyme bout. While I'm ripping the shit, put a clip in the spit. Five rounds, I murder you hoes worse. In a convertible, flipping vertical, nose first. With the top off, landing upside down. You're tied down in duct tape. Fuck rave, I'd rather just hump a slut's leg with my nut shave. It's swaying tech, two disc jockeys breaking so many freaking needles. I wonder if they inject.
Lo and behold.
I like that. Breaking so many needles, I wonder if they inject. You know what I'm saying? Talk about the turntables and the disc jockeys or whatever. You know what I'm saying? Just breaking needles, which happens a lot on old school record players. You know what I'm saying? Talking about, I wonder if they inject. The wordplay right there is kind of crazy too, like the double meanings. That's one good thing about Eminem is like he's always had that ability to, like, you know what I'm saying, like flip the lyrics and flip the meaning behind different words and stuff like that. So I've always appreciated that. And then we got, Chino XL right here. Chino XL. Let's go.
So many freaking needles, I wonder if they inject.
Lo and behold, better than platinum and gold. Yes, God bless success, never forsake your soul. Exhibit, take control, lock loaded and ready to roll. Play the upper hand, the man that's never gonna fold. Cause your tank sucks. Find a new hobby that you can take up. Or listen to my niggas tech and sway so you can wake up. The X-Man, catch me doing drills in the danger room. Big game hunting from high noon to the full moon.
I got to pause right there. I always did appreciate Chino XL, but Exhibit's voice. I thought he always had a great rap voice, you know what I'm saying, and a great rap cadence. And this is obviously before the Pimp My Ride era and all that stuff, you know what I'm saying, for people that even remember that. But I thought it was cool that, you know what I'm saying, he was able to take his career a different direction. But when he first came out, he was definitely on some hardcore, like, street-level type stuff, grimy stuff. You know what I'm saying? And I always did appreciate that from him. And this is Pharoah Monk, I believe.
Synonyms, I get an adrenaline rush from minimum thrust. Plus multiple assaults and small interims. It's already as far as call off was. When I cut your neck, leave a little piece of skin so the head won't fall off.
Boris Karloff lines, you know what I'm saying? The original Dracula. And he's talking about some grimy stuff straight for the holiday season. You know what I'm saying? Cutting heads of the neck, you know, just enough to sever, but not decapitate you. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's what he's talking about.
Hold on, sort of shotgun blast. He asked, why did he have to die like cast metal? See? Now, like with more credit, we prone pedal at a high resolution on the wake up show with Sway Tech and DJ Revolution.
Revolution, 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 revolution.
I sway the tech with the tech and sway. Step away, wet and spray. Represent who over death to pay. Get swept away across the whole board like checker play. When I blaze, your whole sector raise. Wake up show for those who slept away. Niggas that met the trade, hit the deck of prey. DJ Revolution, spinning like lead from out the heck of K. Tearing your neck away. Flood up the street with blood, we decorate. Until the head of...
Yeah, give it up for Cool G Rap.
Take it back to K.
But what you gon' do with it? I can give it to you, but what you gon' do? Rap can give it to you, but what you gon' do with it? I can give it to you, but what?
I like how that was J.O. Felony. I forgot J.O. Felony was even on this song. J.O. Felony had that song, that I could give it to you, but what you gonna do with it? I think he had maybe one other song and then he kind of disappeared. But I remember that song. And that was actually my song. That was my jam back then. You know what I'm saying? I could give it to you, but what? I'm too sexy for my motherhood. Yeah, I like that.
Chino make the world go round.
Chino XL. Oh, Lord.
Fucking up entire record companies like Harrell did to Motown. Vomitous talk, poison pen, ominous walk with flow. Will I destroy you with this time? The most commonest thought.
Oh, man, he's just a problem. Chino XL back then was a problem. Like, he's talking about how messing up record companies like Harrell did to Motown. You know what I'm saying? When he's literally talking about the business of music, talking about when Harrell came in, I forget his name, but that's when Motown Records kind of fell apart. That was like the death knell of Motown because he kind of like killed the company after that. You know what I'm saying? The empire of Motown Records. Think about that. Classic joints, classic records, classic albums. And Motown no longer exists. You know what I'm saying? Not to what level it was anyway. So, yeah, he's talking about that kind of stuff.
The drama that spawned caught us in the midst of a sibling rivalry. For instance, there was nothing born in existence that could survive with me. Clone me like sheep, I clean house like Tony Randall. For style foul, for sexual harassment like Tisha Campbell.
Oh, I forgot about that line. He's about file for sexual harassment like Tisha Campbell. You know, I like the way he elongated that. But Tisha Campbell, you know what I'm saying, is the one that sued Martin Lawrence at the end of the Martin show, because Martin was like messing with her or allegedly sexually harassing her and stuff, and had to sue, and that's what killed the show. You know, Martin, you know what I'm saying? So the fact that he's just bringing all this stuff in, this controversial content in, is wild to me. It's crazy.
You act like Will Smith, your rhyme style is pansy. I fucking murder your young style like JonBenet Ramsey. Now who the master?
Oh, he said I'll murder your style like JonBenet Ramsey. Come on.
To the bag, your demo get passed on a rag. You shouldn't have been signed if you had a white cast on your leg. I wake up.
He said you couldn't have got signed if you had a white cast in your leg. Oh man, let me run that back a little bit.
Clean house like Tony Randall, for style foul, for sexual harassment like Tisha Campbell. You act like Will Smith, your rhyme style is pansy. I fucking murder your young style like JonBenet Ramsey. Now who the master of the bag? Your demo get passed on a rag. You shouldn't have been signed if you had a white cast on your leg. I wake up show reppin' with Sway and Tech. My text like tech in the industry weapon. I'm Chino X, bring KRS in.
And then the rap legend right here, KRS-One, you know what I'm saying?
Coming with the tech and sweat. Yo, I rock upon the littlest set and up on the biggest set. As ill as it gets, I still manage to wiggle your neck with sweat. Never forget, the bigger the budget, the bigger the debt. You gotta be willing to rock in the middle of drying, in the middle of wet. But
I like that. He said, remember the bigger the budget, the bigger the debt. Like he's spitting some real facts at you. You know what I'm saying? Some industry stuff. You know what I'm saying? Because like even back then, it was true as it is today. Like if you're an artist, you take a record deal and the deal's not right, you're going to owe that money back plus some. You'll be indebted to that contract forever. You know what I'm saying? So you got to be careful with stuff like that, young artists out there. If you're lucky enough to get that kind of deal, or nowadays in the modern era, you don't have to worry about it as much because self-promotion is real. You can get out there and do your own thing. Anyway, that took me off on a tangent. Go ahead, KRS-One, let's go.
I'm willing to bet when I sway in attack, they stay in effect. Never been a pain in the neck, they gain the respect. Nevertheless, I'll wreck you. Now you know what Sway and Tech do. I'll be back, but for now, just sackle. Fresh for 1999, you sucker!
That's the way it was, y'all. Do you know 20 years ago, the Sugar Hill Gang was out, and we still don't get no respect?
I never saw that part of the video. That's what's up. So that's the dude from the Sugar Hill Gang, and he's right. Like, at least at the time, they weren't getting no love. Now, if you know about hip-hop history a little bit, the Sugar Hill Gang is like one of the first commercial, I think it was the first commercial rap music that came out to where people understood what rap was. And of course, if we look back now, it might appear like, it's like primitive or whatever, because it's like a 13-minute song or something crazy like that. But it's a party record. It was designed as a party record and a song for people to just dance to and have fun to. You know what I'm saying? But the story behind that is crazy. Like the way that that song came together and the lady that put it together and how people didn't even want to be on the track. And then it ended up being like the foundational song for hip hop, you know, is amazing. So if you ever get a chance to watch the documentary about the Sugar Hill Gang or how the song came together, do that. Like it's really cool, especially if you're a fan of music or even the music behind the music or the tales behind the music of the stories. Like it's really cool to kind of check that stuff out. So, but that's why I like appreciate stuff like this, because this launched like, this is like the beginning level of Eminem's career. You know what I'm saying? Back when he first came on, the Wake Up Show was the hot show to go on. There was a talk show at the time, you know, still is, of course, it's still around today. But for an artist to get on the Wake Up Show and actually get a chance to perform and rap and be out there was dope. And then this was a project, I believe, from Sway and King Tech. And they put together, you know what I'm saying, like almost like almost like a super group in a way of like artists that they respected and that they wanted to kind of highlight at the time that they wanted to give shine to. And they wanted to kind of pay homage to the OGs as well. So they put together this roster, and that's why there's so many people on this track. But it was like a ridiculous roster. Like, look at this. You got the RZA from the Wu-Tang Clan. You got Tech N9ne, you know what I'm saying? As he was coming up, Eminem, and he was coming up. Exhibit, like right at the beginning of his career, like when he was about to get out there and start messing stuff up. Pharrell Monk, he was a lyrical, ridiculous lyrical genius, and he still is. Cool G Rap was an OG. Chino XL, same position. He was on his way up. KRS-One, on his, you know what I'm saying, OG in the game. And then JL Felony, you know, who had the record. He had the hit record at the time, if I remember right. Like right around that time frame is when his song was blowing up. So of course they put him on because the song was a hit. And just to be able to have that vision to put together a group like this and put it out there is really, really cool. You know what I'm saying? So just a little hip-hop history for y'all. I don't know if y'all hip-hop heads or not like that. I listened to a lot of hip-hop growing up, so that's why I'm, you know, somewhat knowledgeable, at least on this kind of stuff. So anyway, yo, I'm going to get up out of here. Shout out to Eminem. Happy birthday to the dude. You know what I'm saying? Hopefully my other video gets up at some point in the next few days or so. We'll see. We'll see if YouTube will allow it to go up. Of course, by then it'll be after birthday post, but whatever, who cares? It's all right. So anyway, I'm gonna get ready for some new videos, get those up here. I'm going back to requests after this, so these are just a couple ones I wanted to put out there, and the next ones coming up are going to be the requests I need to catch up on. So please stay tuned, check me out. Definitely comment, like, all that good stuff to, you know, support my channel and help me grow, and I appreciate that. So without further ado, I'm gonna get up out of here. This is Marvin again with more Maverick, with those Marvin reactions, and I will catch y'all in the next video. All right, y'all be safe, take care of yourself, peace.